Aunt Jenny is probably one of the most renowned people in all of North Alabama. She was like you or I, no different. She was born in Kentucky, and she met Willis Brooks, her first husband, at a very, very young age. As a matter of fact, she was only about 14 years old. He was 20 years her senior, and she and Willis moved into what we know as the Bankhead National Forest. They had about 120 acres, and all they ever wanted to do was farm and raise their family and live the life just like you and I. However, when that Civil War came along, everything changed for Aunt Jenny. And that is truly where Aunt Jenny's life story begins. I always tell that a lot of things I think that happened with Aunt Jenny and who Aunt Jenny was is everything I've ever heard is that Aunt Jenny had Cherokee blood. So I believe that a lot of things with Aunt Jenny came from that blood and those roots. But Aunt Jenny and Willis had 10 children. One of those had died in childbirth, but that left them with 9 children around the time that the Civil War came along. Most folks in this part of the country didn't want any issues, any side, none whatsoever. They just simply wanted to be left alone and not bothered. They didn't want to join either side. And Aunt Jenny and Willis were nonetheless. And by all means, even Willis, Willis Sr. had already fought in a war before, and as I said, he was 20 years older than Aunt Jenny, so he certainly didn't want any part of it. Their oldest son, John, he was 19 already, and so obviously both sides felt like both men should be joining up. The story goes, and there's varying stories, by the way, and you all, I'm sure, know that as history passes down through the decades and generations, that sometimes it gets distorted, okay? So let me tell you that what I try to be as factual as possible, but there are varying accounts of what happened and why. But the best that I can determine is that, as I said, they didn't want to join either side. But there was a skirmish over there, and if any of you are familiar with the Bankhead area, or Byler Road especially, you know how far Byler Road ran. And Byler Road, the original Byler Road, ran through or in front of the Brooks family farm. And there was a skirmish along that way. It is said that the Union Army was headed down to Kinlock Falls, as we know it now. Back then, it was called Hubbard Creek because Major David Hubbard had a summer home out there, and he had slaves. They had a mill down there. Story has it that the Union Army knew if they could get down there to that mill and destroy it, they would put a hurting on the Confederate Army. So the skirmish happened, and as the story goes, there were Union soldiers left dead. Those Union men told them, "You leave them laying. You let the varmints and the vultures have them. They don't deserve a decent burial." Now, how many of you would actually do that? Whether it was your worst enemy, or someone you knew and cared about. None of us would, right? Nobody wants dead bodies laying on your property. So it is said that Aunt Jenny and her family buried those men. And following that, as hard as I tried to prove that it wasn't, they say that the Confederate Army came in, Confederate Home Guards, that is, and said, "Then if you're not for us, you must be against us." They killed Willis Sr. and Aunt Jenny's oldest son, John. Brutally tortured and murdered them. It is said that this is the beginning of the legend of Aunt Jenny Brooks. They say she went into a rage and decided that vengeance was to be had at all cost. It is said that she took her remaining sons, and that was all the way down to about the age of 2, and made them lay their hands on those cold dead bodies and swear that with every fiber of their being, those men would pay with their lives for what they had done to her family. Now, I have to say at this point that history shows that it probably cost Aunt Jenny more than she ever banked on, more than it was worth. Because this vengeance would span decades, it would end up involving her sons, her son-in-laws, and her grandsons, and even others. By the time Aunt Jenny died, all 10 children were gone but one. All 5 sons reportedly died by some type of gun wound. In one gunfight in Oklahoma, on one day, she lost a son and a grandson. We should never feel the pain of losing a child. And how Aunt Jenny ever survived to be able to live to be 90, 98, I'll never understand. Because as I said, she lost a lot. The grief should have been unbearable. There should have been a lot of bitterness and anger. But I am sure that a lot of those stories is what made people fearful of who Aunt Jenny was, because she is credited in an early Birmingham newspaper stating that they had all been gotten but one, and she possibly got a couple of them herself. Some of the stories are brutal, how these men were hunted down and taken out. But even in the end, even if you might not necessarily like Aunt Jenny, you had to have a deep respect for the kind of person that she actually was. How she loved deeply her family, her friends, and her community.